Lincoln Road with the first start of the night.
To Will Height three times. She cannot put it away and they end up stuffing her down. That's going to give Missouri confidence right out of the gate.
As that time it was Melanie Crow getting the stuff and Missouri's up 2-0.
You can see that Missouri has really game planned to try to slow down the strength of Minnesota, and that, of course, is Sarah Wilhite.
Service error by Eckenrode. So back to serve for Minnesota will be the Big Ten Setter of the Year, Samantha Seliger-Swenson from Minnetonka, Minnesota, also an academic All-Big Ten performer this year. Tooling the block is Kyra Larson.
Kyra Larson, she is fiery. She's the leader out on that court. She wants the ball every single time. Here is that back set. She cranks it angle before the blocker can get set.
Crow, one of the best servers in the SEC, and you have to say in the country, but she only gets one serve as Paige Tapp hammers it for the Gophers.
Paige Tapp, that 6'1 senior middle with that backslide extending, going cross court. Always an effective play.
You'll hear the name Tapp a lot tonight. Her twin sister Hannah is also a starter for Minnesota. Munden is dropped.
You know, Sam, we always talk about serve and pass. It's going to be very vital for Missouri to pass that ball in a very hittable position. Keep that ball in system. Stay out of trouble.
I hit the antenna, so a point to Minnesota. I think you touched on it well there, Dana. Staying in system for a team like Missouri against a team like Minnesota on Minnesota's home court is absolutely crucial.
A missed opportunity for Missouri. They go to the back set. They are dug by Minnesota, and Minnesota runs that backslide to perfection.
4-0 run right now by the Golden Gophers. Absolutely perfect. Alexis Hart places that in the back corner. A member of the all-freshman Big Ten team and the North Region Freshman of the Year. So Wilhite enjoying a nice service run here. Good receive. And there's Carly Kahn.
That's what I love about Carly Kahn from Punahou in Honolulu, Hawaii. She has such a variety of shots. She can hit with that power. She can turn that ball and really control it with finesse. And she's just a great all-around player.
Such a dynamic player, too, because when you look at her physically, she seems small. Good dip by Wilhite. And hard again.
Rush cross court right there by Alexis Hart.
How about that shot placement, Dane? Her two kills have been very tough.
That's interesting. You learn, and as you mature, that it's not the straight down hit you always want. If you go deep to the corners, it's very difficult to dig as a defensive player.
She's such a freshman. Back row attack from Crow. Crow is looking for a touch. Doesn't get the call. Point Minnesota.
Remember, that's what we need. Melanie Crow crushing that ball, but she's got to keep it in, or Minnesota's going to take full advantage.
Missouri started strong, but Minnesota has come roaring back, leading 8-4 in our first timeout. Saturday after Thanksgiving.
That's pretty incredible how they finished so strong in the end of the season. And there you see a second error in a row by Melanie Crow. And you know, one thing that we haven't mentioned yet, Sam, is that Minnesota, they do not lose on this court.
Not
15-0 this year as well as last year. So to come in here and get a win, you got to play almost perfect.
Minnesota fourth in the nation in attendance this year, and it is packed tonight. Six straight sellouts coming into this match. Khan sides out for Missouri.
What a great hit right there. You said Carly Khan seems small. It's not that she seems small. She is small at 5'9". When you got these 6'5", 6'4" players, she's undersized, but she plays way much bigger than that 5'9" frame.
Comes from a football family. Her dad played quarterback for the Chargers, and her brother was a quarterback at USC. Golden Gophers currently in the midst of a 34-0 match win streak. They have not lost on this court since 2014. That was very much in doubt the night before Thanksgiving when they were down two sets to Nebraska on this court, but found that Golden Gopher magic and came back and won. Shaw with the serve, first time she's been in the match. Khan again, a little off speed.
That was incredible. Looked like she was going to hit, and that's what an effective offensive player does. She looks like she's going to crush the ball, and she breaks out the finesse. Carly Khan, one of the best in the business at doing so.
Former SEC scholar, athlete of the year, very cerebral player. Good dig by Etheridge.
Crush that ball. That's been a big thing with McCutcheon, trying to get her to kind of have some varied shots, but when you have that cannon working every time, how can you slow her down?
Service error. That's the first on the Golden Gophers. Point to Missouri. Hart has three kills, six attempts, no errors. Back to serve is Emily Fader. She's a 6'3 senior middle from Springfield, Missouri. The fourth Tiger with over 400 career total blocks. And how about that? The setter, Samantha Seliger-Swinson, finding that opening in the Tiger defense.
That's why she's the Big Ten setter of the year right here. Smart, cerebral play. Knowing she's a little off balance, uses that left hand to go right in the heart of the Missouri defense for the kill.
Rosado, the libero, serving.
Transition. It's one thing to make a defensive play, but then to get set, turn it around into offense immediately. Minnesota so good at doing so.
Only the first kill for Will Height. Oh, good dig. Fans appreciating that by Shaw. Point Minnesota.
How about Samantha Seliger-Swinson down the line? Just digging that ball straight up. That was incredible.
Rosado back to serve a childhood friend of former Golden Gopher great Dolly Santana from Puerto Rico. Dolly Santana now playing professionally in France. Service ace for Rosado. That's her 25th ace of the season. Now they are fired up here in Minnesota. It's a 4-0 Minnesota run, and they lead big time, 15-7.
Loud, and it's got to be good for about 4 or 5 points for Minnesota each and every set. It's just an incredible atmosphere.
The volleyball team started playing here in 94.
Coming out, she, if you ask me, is the go-to player right now.
Four kills for Khan, no errors. Will Hite is wide. Two in a row for the Tigers. Eckenrode back to serve. She's been Missouri's setter since they switched to a 5-1. That happened back in September. They played the nine matches with a 6-2. Switched over to a 5-1 and have been a much different team since then.
Just like that, Paige Tapp hits that ball into the net, and we're just with a 5-point difference here. So Missouri really trying to mount a front.
Larson, that might have been going out, but it is point Missouri. And that's another trait of this Missouri team. We've been impressed all year because we've covered them on the SEC Network at their composure. They very rarely get rattled. So if you're going to have a team be able to handle this environment, it's going to be Missouri, and they're back to within four.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. When you just come to look at this match right in the middle, they might be down 7 or 8 points, but they're not going to see it with the body language. There's not that frustration. They're very composed, and you got to give a lot of credit to Wayne Breklow. It's the kind of culture that he cultivates at Missouri to always be fighting regardless of what that scoreboard says.
Well, the NCAA Women's Volleyball Championship coverage continues with the national semifinals Thursday, December 15th at 7 Eastern on ESPN2. For more information on the NCAA Women's Volleyball Championship, visit NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. And what a dramatic day it has been today all across the country in our debut season of having no predetermined regionals. These home teams are supposed to have such a huge advantage, and so far the top seeds have all been pushed to 5 sets.
Yeah, it's just been really an incredible day where we almost saw Nebraska go down, we almost saw Wisconsin, Texas at the brink, and you wonder if that could happen right here on this very court.
Well, the seeds holding. In Lincoln, Nebraska, though, was down 2 match points in the third set to Penn State. Washington then sweeping Arizona. That could be a tough one for Nebraska tomorrow at 4 Eastern. Texas waiting to see whether it will play Creighton or Michigan. And Texas almost lost as well. Say 2 match points in the fifth set. Missouri right now on a 4-0 run. 5 in a row, and Carly Khan has 5 of her team's 7 kills.
Yeah, Carly Khan is the go-to player. She has the hot hand. Give a lot of credit right there. Alexa Etheridge getting that ball up, then Khan out of the pipe, middle position against 3 blockers, crushing it and putting it away.
Now, Will Hite shaking up a little bit on that play. Kim McCutcheon came out on the court. She stays in the game in the right back position. Swenson trying to do it again, could not this time. And whatever it was that was wrong with Will Hite, nothing wrong there. She's shaking it off.
She does look like she's moving around a little gingerly, I guess. Taking a look at the last play. There's Will Hite, number 8, at the net. She rolls that right ankle. There it is. She lands on number 4, Paige Tapp's foot, and rolls the ankle slightly. So if she keeps playing, that thing probably will not tighten up. It's when you stop playing is when those ankles really get to you.
Well, she came back and got a kill. There's Missouri getting out of system. Little miscommunication there on the Tiger side of the net. Seliger Swinson back to serve, 17-12 here in this opening set in the best of 5-set match. The winner moves on to the regional final, which is the last 8 in the NCAA tournament. And Crow misses. That is a as a point to Minnesota. Crows had trouble getting going, Dave.
Yeah, when you try to hit an angle that sharp and the ball clips the top of the net, a lot of times you run out of real estate and miss it just wide.
Well, you have to get a kill for the Tigers. Well, good received by Kahn.
Kills a set, an all Big Ten honorable mention. She gets up early for her setter and puts that ball straight down. Great play.
6'3" junior from Mankato, Minnesota. Rosado saves it.
Minnesota really is aware of that back set to Kira Larson, and they're defending it well. It's a tough rotation for Mizzou.
So Sawyer Swenson comes from a volleyball family. Her mom's a very good, successful high school volleyball coach in this area. Hopkins High School. We have another recruit coming in from Hopkins as well. Alyssa Munlin getting the kill in the middle for the Tigers. Munlin, all SEC and a former SEC Freshman of the Year. Now in her sophomore season. She touches 10-7.
The 6'3" junior middle blocker is coming up big here late in set number one.
She's had 4 swings and 4 kills, Lohman, in that middle blocker position, 13 in white. Here's Will Height serving.
Wow, what a serve. That was a nice jump float serve. A risky serve going line to line, but Will Height pinpoints it just perfect. And it goes to show you how tough that serve is with Carly Kahn back there, one of the best passers in the nation.
She's had 2 aces already tonight. Minnesota closing in on the opening set.
Dodged a bullet right there. They had a few opportunities, just could not get the offense clicking. And fortunately for them, Minnesota ends up hitting that ball out of bounds. Here you see on the replay, there's so many opportunities, and they have to start capitalizing on those.
I love that hustle. Tap diving over Rosado, trying to get that dig. That's been a pretty good pattern for Hart, that cross-court attack.
If you're Mizzou, you want to bring that block in. You want to tempt Hart to hit down the line. She's already showed she really favors that cross court.
H-Tap back to serve. 3 kills today for Tap. Still going.
Crushing that ball. You see what Minnesota's doing. They're serving right down the line, especially in these rotations, and they're causing all sorts of problems for Mizzou's offense to run correctly.
Set point, Minnesota. And Larson extends the set.
That was so interesting, the fact that Alexis Hart had a one-on-one situation, and that time she tried to turn it down the line.
Still set point for the Golden Gophers. Well, the Tap sisters come up big in set number one. Hannah ends the set, and the Gophers in 2:27 to take the opening set by 10.